Wow. In case you wonder why I'm saying wow, it's because of the colour of the water. Where I am up here now, it's always really, really clear. And very small, you can step across it. Yeah, it just looks like a normal sized trout stream. The normal, just a nibble. Got him. Yes, just about to say, the normal sized trout stream, which is the bottom end of this hole, is like a raging, the bottom end of this creek is a raging torrent, and you just can't fish it at the moment. So I have come all the way up here to wet a line in the hope that there might be a little bit smaller. And even still, even way up here, it's still really, really dirty. Mate, just sit still because I want to take you a photograph and then I'm going to put you back. And that'll make you really happy because you'd like to be back in the water because that's where you live. Right. Well, there's a bit of blood. He's hooked a bit deep, but I reckon he'll be okay. See you later, mate. I didn't see where he went. I didn't see him go over the rapids there. I think he'll be fine. Gee whiz, look at the colour of the water. I decided to stop in down low in the main part of the creek where I usually fish. And I had one cast into a hole there with a bubble float, a hole that I always catch fish, but it was so high and dirty. It was just insanely high and off colour. So I thought, oh no, I'll sneak up to a nice quiet little spot right up high in the creek that I know about and see if I can catch a fish up there. And I actually thought this spot would be a little bit clearer. Well, it is a bit clearer, but it's still very high and dirty. No, no, just no. It wasn't deep, but there's no structure for fish to hide behind. There's one there though, I saw it. Got him. Look at that. Oh, off he went. Lovely little rainbow trout. Ooh, got him. He followed that out. He got off too. Did you see that? He followed that out. He chased it out of the water. That's two in two casts. I was pulled up at this bit of a culvert here and thought I might just have a quick flick. Oh, missed him, I had another bite. I kid you not, I had my third bite. I've hooked two and lost two and then had another bite. I've got Loretta back at the car waiting for me. She's actually doing it. Here's a follow. Take it, he's right on it. She was actually doing a bit of metal detecting at the campground where my car's parked. Escorted it out, but he didn't hit it. Despite me pausing it, he still didn't hit it. He's on it. He wants it. Hit it. Oh my God. He had his mouth open and he was swirling around it. They really are playing hardball today, I can tell you. It's almost like he was making love to the lure. He's on it again. Not a big fish. Probably not even 30 centimetres. Oh, he's going stupid around this lure. He's doing everything with it except striking it. A bit further up this time. Except there's a second. Oh, something strike that. I saw a swirl. Something's following it. Look at the swirl, look. Look, he's attacking it. Oh, they are playing hardball. Something shocking today. He's on it. Got him. Oh, I lost him. After all that, I lost him anyway. This can be a very tough time of year to catch fish. That's a nice spot. And my secateurs, I think, are not in my bag. I think they're in the car. Oh, yeah. Very smart. A lot. I'm gonna go through here and get stuck like Velcro. I can hear lots of grunting and groaning and moaning. Right, now make the cast. That's a bit excessive for me, this is just stupid. I don't mind fishing in overgrown spots, but this is ridiculous. It's going to be quite difficult to cast into there. What I might do is pull my split shot right down so it's closer to the worms. That'll give me greater control over my casting. A trout. Got him! Yes, oh, he's wrapped me around that log. Here he is. Oh, now he's wrapped me around the tree. He's wrapped me around the log, then he's wrapped me around the tree. We're in a hell of a mess. Right. Come on, Mr. Brown Trout. I didn't even feel the bite. I just saw that he swam near me worms. So I set the hook and it was game on. Look at that. Lovely little brown trout. Caught at a creek crossing on a four-wheel drive track on a bunch of worms. Mate, I'm just trying to get you unhooked and then you're good to go. There we go, lovely little brown trout. See ya, mate.
Off he goes.
Now, a moment ago, I said I was going to slide my sinker down closer to the hook to help me cast better. I'll just explain that. If I have the split shot way up there, when I'm casting the split shot because that's most of the weight. And what that does, it goes through the air and it drags this hook with the worms on it. That just sways around and risks getting tangled. Okay in open areas, not okay in enclosed areas. So by sliding the sinker right down close to the hook like that, it puts the weight closer to the end and this gives me greater control over my cast. Now, there's only that much swinging around behind the sinker as it passes through the air, which means it's a lot less likely to get snagged. Lovely little brown trout. Keep breaking half. You know, I don't tell Dad jokes very often in my videos, but when I do, he really gets a kick out of it. Seriously, folks. As you know, I've been on a bit of a weight loss campaign. I've lost a bit of weight. I was going to go on the all almond diet. Nothing but almonds. But seriously, that's just nuts.